come to visit your local market only at night when the vendors are selling their vegetables away at throwaway prices. And that has been the case with many Indian households. Fruits and meat have been out of reach, milk has been an occasional treat. Amid the climb in retail inflation across India and the increase in food prices, Russia's invasion of Ukraine is more than a conflict between two nations. It's more than a war. It's bigger than NATO. It's bigger than Putin. It has been a crisis with global consequences. And the escalation in global grocery prices has really exacerbated the difficulties faced by agriculturists. Why? Because of increased greenhouse gas emissions, disruptions in Black Sea trade, which accounts for about 90% of Ukraine's grain exports, right? The Black Sea trade has been responsible for about 90% of Ukraine's grain exports, and environmental fertilizer price increases, and increases in temperature, as was the case with India, which had been reeling from a heat wave earlier this year. Climate change has been a theme that many talking heads have increasingly discussed on the heels of the conflict in Ukraine. The war released about 33 million tons of greenhouse gases, warming up the Earth's atmosphere. And you know that causes weird weather patterns, increases in temperature, harvest disruptions, melting of ice caps, and so on and so forth. So, where is your place in the world against this backdrop? What can you do as a climate change influencer? It could be something as simple as just talking about climate change or spreading awareness in the immediate neighborhood or community. You, as a person with an economics background, will understand the concept of the multiplier effect, right? So if you go to a school, 6, 7, 8 grade, and if you talk to, let's say, 20 school students about climate change, 5 of those students might be inspired to take action. And each of those 5 people might, spread the word to, say, 10 people. So that's 50 people now who have been spoken to, right? Of those 50 people, 25 might be inspired to spread the word further. At least of those 25 people might end up talking to, let's say, 30 people or so. So that's 750 people who have not been reached. So this way you can reach millions of people. So that is the exponential or multiplier effect. Now, speaking of climate change, carbon emissions are like one of the biggest sources of climate change problems. So if a company spews carbon out into the atmosphere, the company has to pay someone to buy that carbon, right? So let's say Tesla has been selling a ton of carbon credits to car companies. And let's imagine you own a Hyundai SUV, and that SUV spews carbon out into the atmosphere. Hyundai would go to Tesla and say that, hey, sell me hundreds of millions of dollars in carbon credits. Now Tesla is an electric company, so it has zero carbon emissions. So how do you decide the clearing price of carbon? How do economics affect that price? How do you zero in on a price that is, affordable and sustainable? How do you quantify the price of carbon, and how do you fix a price in a way that can incentivize car makers and civilians and everyone to reduce carbon emissions? So that is the kind of thinking that anybody needs to think like a leader. You can get involved in carbon markets and make a whole career out of it.